نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه وخليله أدى الأمانة وبلغ الرسالة ونصح للأمة وكشف الغمة وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك عليه أفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم وعلى آله وصحبه ومن استنى بسنته إلى يوم الدين اللهم اجعلنا منهم ومن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر آمين يا رب العالمين قال الله تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا قال الله تعالى في القرآن المجيد بعد أن أقول أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وما محمد إلا رسول قد خلت من قبله الرسل أفإن مات أو قتل انقلبتم على أعقابكم ومن ينقلب على عقبيه فلن يضر الله شيئا وسيجزي الله الشاكرين وما كان لنفس أن تموت إلا بإذن الله كتابا مؤجلا ومن يرد ثواب الدنيا نؤته منها ومن يرد ثواب الآخرة نؤته منها وسنجزي الشاكرين اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي استغفر الله ربنا من كل ذنب ونتوب إليك ربنا زدنا علما اللهم يسر ولا تعسر وتمم الخير اللهم إنا نسألك لذة النظر إلى وجهك والشوق إلى لقائك آمين يا رب العالمين الحمد لله Today, in today's khutbah, I would like to talk about the final days of our beloved Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ramadan came and Ramadan went. Every Ramadan, Jibreel alayhi salam would come and visit our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and review the Quran with him. Last 10 nights of Ramadan, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam spent with Jibreel alayhi salam reviewing the Quran in i'tikaf. Comes the 10th year of Hijrah, 10 years after the migration of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to Medina. Jibreel alayhi salam comes to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and says, Ya Rasulullah, extend your i'tikaf. This year, you will not do 10 days of i'tikaf, rather you will do 20 days of i'tikaf. And this year, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam recites the Quran to Jibreel alayhi salam twice. This year was special. And so after Jibreel alayhi salam left, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is thinking, why twice this year? Why twice? What is special? What's so special about this year? You see, when the Dhul Arsh al-Majid, when the Fa'alu lima yurid, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he gives a hint, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the first one to understand that. He got the message. He got the message that this is probably my final year in this world. That Allah wants to make sure that the message has been conveyed. He wants to review the Quran twice to make sure the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam got it, to make sure the Ummah gets it right, and this final message is preserved in its entirety. And so, you know, the Prophet ﷺ does not give any hint to anybody about his leaving. He got the message, but he does not convey to any of his ummah. And then he, as he's, you know, giving farewell to Mu'adh radiallahu anhu, Mu'adh bin Jabal, Mu'adh radiallahu anhu, as he's leaving to Yemen, the Prophet ﷺ is walking with Mu'adh as he's sending him off to Yemen. Mu'adh is riding on the camel, and our Rasul ﷺ is walking beside him, giving him advice. And towards the end of his advice, he says, O Mu'adh, today you're going, but next time you come back to Medina, you might not see me. You might not see me here. And Mu'adh radiallahu anhu cries and feels for this. He understands what the Prophet means, that he will not be back in Medina. But Mu'adh radiallahu anhu still goes to Yemen, because I'm going to follow what my messenger said. Yes, it's sad, but I will only do what my messenger does. That's true love. And then the Prophet wasallam, he sends messengers across the Arabian Peninsula, inviting people to come for Hajj. This year, the Rasul is going for Hajj. He invites all the people to come and see. You see, the people have heard about Rasulullah. They have not seen him. They have not sat with him. They did not talk to him. So this year, the Prophet wants to make sure that everybody comes and benefits from this. So messengers were sent inviting people for Hajj. And the scholars say that 100,000 camels come for Hajj this year. More than 100,000 camels flock together and come into Medina. And she come into Mecca to do the Hajj with Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, 4 days before Zulqa'idah, the 11th month of the Islamic calendar, 4 days before Zulqa'idah, he marches out to Dhul Hulayfa and he prays the Dhuhr and he starts his journey towards Hajj. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reaches Mecca, and in Dhul Hijjah he performs his Hajj rituals. And on the day of Arafah, after he finishes his dua and his time at Arafah, the Prophet ﷺ gives his farewell speech. This is called the Khutba to Hajjat al-Wada', which is the final farewell speech of Rasulullah ﷺ, the final things that he has to say for his ummah. And what does he say? First thing he says, O Muslims, your blood. O Muslims, your blood. O Muslims, your blood, your wealth, and your honor is sacred. Just like this day and this month and this place is sacred. O Muslim, take care of yourself, honor each other. Just like how you honor Mecca, just like how you honor this month of Hajj, honor each other and take care of each other's wealth and blood. And he says that your blood of Jahiliyyah, the blood of Jahiliyyah is abrogated. That means after today, whatever harm you have done, I have forgiven everybody. There is no retaliation, there is no qisas. Everything is under my foot, abrogated. Nothing will be accountable. After this day, there will be no revenge. There will be no avenge. There will be no retaliations. Nothing. Everybody is forgiven. And then the Prophet says that riba is forbidden completely. That interest, dealing with interest, is completely haram. And then the Prophet says, be good to your women. O Muslims, be good to your women, because you have taken them in the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Meaning that your women have become halal to you because of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because of this nikah that you have done in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So take care of them and guard their rights and take care of them. And the Prophet says that I have left two things with you. I am leaving two things with you. You know his fable speech as he's saying goodbye to the ummah. Says, yes, we all have to leave, but I'm leaving something behind which will guide you and keep you connected to Allah and His Messenger. What are those two things? First thing he says is the Quran. I'm leaving behind the book of Allah and the lineage of the Prophet ﷺ, my sunnah and my practices. Whoever holds on to it will never be misled. And then the Prophet ﷺ says, addressing the ummah at this time, the ummah was 144,000 people. And then he addresses all of them and he says, O people, on the day of judgment, when Allah will ask you about me, what will you say? Allah says in the Quran, فَلَنَسْأَلَنَّ الَّذِينَ أُرْسِلَ إِلَيْهِمْ وَلَنَسْأَلَنَّ الْمُرْسَلِينَ. We will ask the people about their messenger, and we will ask the messenger about the people. So the Prophet ﷺ wants to make sure that what is the message, what is the response that they will give. So he asks, what will you tell Allah when Allah asks you about me? And then the ummah replies, we will say that you have conveyed the message. Ya Rasulullah, we will say that you have relayed this message to us and we got the message. And that's why we have Nasah al-Ummah wa Kashaf al-Ghummah, right? Wa tarakna ala al-mahajjat al-bayda', the words that I started my khutbah with, those same words the ummah replies to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he looks to the heavens and then he says, Allahumma fashhad, Allahumma fashhad, Allahumma fashhad. He says, O Allah, you be witness to this. O Allah, you be witness to this. O Allah, you be witness to this. And then he says, as he's saying these words, Jibreel alayhi salam, he descends with the final ayah, or an ayah from Surah Ma'idah, which says, اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا. Today I have perfected and completed my religion and my favors upon you, and I have made Islam as a religion that is pleasing to you. And then the Prophet ﷺ recites these ayat to the Ummah. And then the next day, on the 10th of Dhul Hijjah, the Prophet ﷺ assembles again, gathers everybody, and he gives a similar khutbah. At this time, Surah Al-Nasr was revealed. إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ وَالْفَتْحِ وَرَأَيْتَ النَّاسَ يَدْخُلُونَ فِي دِينِ اللَّهِ أَفْوَاجًا فَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ وَاسْتَغْفِرْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ تَوَّابًا. Says, when victory comes to you, Ya Rasulullah, إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ وَالْفَتْحِ, and the help of Allah and Fath comes to you, what should you do? وَرَأَيْتَ النَّاسَ يَدْخُلُونَ فِي دِينِ اللَّهِ أَفْوَاجًا. You will see that the people are entering into Islam in rows upon rows. What should you do? Do the tasbih of Allah, praise Allah, and seek His forgiveness. Indeed, He is all forgiving. And you know, Rasulullah ﷺ, he says, this surah was as if Allah is doing the condolence for Rasulullah ﷺ. And then he says, when he says this, Jibreel ﷺ says, Ya Rasulullah, indeed the akhirah is better for you. The hereafter is better for you. And then the month of Hajj ends, and the Muharram goes through, and then Safar begins on the 27th of Safar, the second month of Islamic calendar. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he goes to Abu Muwahhiba in the middle of the night. He says, oh Abu Muwahhiba, come with me, my Lord has commanded that I should go to Jannatul Baqi' and give favor and make dua for the people, come with me. So Abu Muwahhiba radiallahu anhu, he accompanies the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam goes to Jannatul Baqi' and he makes dua for these people, and he gives his farewell dua. He says, O dwellers of the grave, good news to you. O dwellers of the grave, good news to you, for indeed you are in a better place than the people who are living in this world. You are in a better place than the people who are living in this world, because as time goes by, calamities are only increasing. Calamities are unleashed, and it's only going to get worse and worse and worse. So your place is much better than the people in this dunya. And then the Prophet ﷺ turns to Abu Muwahhiba, and then he says, you know, Allah has given me a choice. Allah has given me a choice. The choice is that I can live in this dunya as long as I want, until for eternity, until the dunya ends, I can stay in this dunya and still not lose my position in the akhirah. Or the other option Allah has given me is that I should leave and meet Him. And so Abu Muwahhiba says, Ya Rasulullah, stay with us. Choose the first option. Stay with us. Guide your ummah. See your ummah flourish and grow. Stay with us, Ya Rasulullah. And the Prophet says, no, I have chosen the other. I have chosen to meet the Dhul Arsh al-Majid, fa'alu lima yureed. I have chosen to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a choice the Prophet ﷺ made. And then the Prophet ﷺ, he goes, and the next day he has a high fever. Right? He attends a funeral actually. After that he has a high fever. And the Prophet ﷺ's fever was so high that they could feel the heat through his turban. Right? That's how high his fever was. And then Aisha radiallahu anha says, oh, my head hurts. Right, when she sees Rasulullah in this state, she says, my head hurts. And the Prophet says, no, Ya Aisha, is in fact my head that hurts, not yours. But the beauty is that Rasulullah does not stop. He continues to do his daily things with the headache, with the fever he had, that he would visit his wives and convey the message and talk to the people and do everything he was doing, completing his task before leaving this world. And then Bilal radiallahu anhu, he gives the adhan. He calls the adhan, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam for the first time does not have the energy to get up and go and lead the ummah for salah. And so he calls the people and he tells his companions to throw some water so that he can make wudu. So he makes wudu. As he's making wudu, he faints again. He faints again. And then after a few minutes, he gets up and says, did the people pray yet? Did the people pray yet? No, Ya Rasulullah, they're waiting for you. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, pour some water, and he makes wudu. As he's making wudu, he faints again. And then he dozes off, and then he gets up, and he gains consciousness. He says, did the people pray yet? And then no, Ya Rasulullah, they're waiting for you. And then he makes wudu. This happens quite a few times, and then he says, tell Abu Bakr to lead salah. Tell Abu Bakr to lead salah. And then Aisha radiallahu anha says, Ya Rasulullah, Abu Bakr cannot lead salah. Can you ask Umar to lead? No, tell Abu Bakr to lead salah. Again and again and again, he says Abu Bakr to lead salah. And then finally Abu Bakr continues to lead salah until the Prophet ﷺ gains strength. So for the next few days, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, he's leading the salah for the ummah. And then one day, and then the Prophet ﷺ, he tells his companions to take him to the member. One day he gains a little bit of strength, so he asks his companions to lift him and take him to the member of his masjid. And then the Prophet ﷺ sits on his member for the last time in his life. He sits on his member and he says, "If I have hurt anybody in my life, here is my stick. Take qisas on me. Take the retaliation and take your revenge on me today." And then he says, he turns to the people, "Is there anybody who I owe any money to? If I owe any money to anybody, please come forward and get the money from me today." And one sahabi says, "Ya Rasulullah, you owe me 4 dirhams. And then he gives him, and who asked him for money, he gave everything. And then he prays, and then he asks the companions again, "Is there anybody who I owe anything? Or if I hurt, here is my back. Go ahead and take the revenge on me." And then after that, the Prophet ﷺ says something beautiful. He says to the companions, A servant of Allah was given the choice to stay in this world or to meet his Rabb. But this servant has chosen to meet his Rabb. At this point, Abu Bakr starts crying and crying and crying, and people are thinking, why is he crying? Because the Prophet says a servant was given a choice. He did not say himself. But Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, he understood this message. This was actually Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And so Abu Bakr cries and cries and cries and says, "Ya Rasulullah, we will sacrifice our household for you. We will give up everything for you. Please stay back." And then Rasulullah says, "Oh ya Abu Bakr, sit down. Sit down, listen to me. Do not cry." And then Abu Bakr, the Prophet says, "All the doors of this masjid can be closed, but the door of Abu Bakr will never be closed." What that means is, and if you go today to Masjid al-Nabawi, the door that you enter to see Rasulullah's place, his grave, is the door of Abu Bakr. You'll see Abu Bakr, because that's the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, that the door of Abu Bakr, the door where he comes from, his houses, that place cannot be closed. And so the Prophet says, the door of Abu Bakr will not be closed. And he says to the people, "I have repaid to everybody in my life, but I have never repaid to Abu Bakr for his companionship, for his money. I can never pay him." And he says, only Allah will repay Abu Bakr. And he says, "If I were to have a friend besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after Allah, if I were to have a Khalil, that would have been Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu." And then on Saturday, 2 days before the passing away of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam enters the masjid as Abu Bakr is leading salah. As Abu Bakr is leading salah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam enters, and then Abu Bakr sees the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he moves back. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, he puts his hand on him and he says, he pushes him forward, "Go, stay where you are." And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stands to the left side of Abu Bakr, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was leading the prayer by his actions, just moving his head, and Abu Bakr was leading the ummah in prayer. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was like moving his head, Abu Bakr was doing the action, and the ummah was following Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu anhu. And then so days go by, and the next day, Sunday, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he goes to Aisha radiyallahu anha and says, "Oh Aisha, here are 7 dinars. I have given everything to the people. Here are 7 dinars. Go and give this in sadaqah. Go and give these 7 dinars in sadaqah." And so the Prophet ﷺ says this and he dozes off and he gets up. "Oh Aisha, did you give those 7 dinars in sadaqah?" And Aisha says, "No, Ya Rasulullah, I was busy in taking care of you." "Oh Aisha, give this 7 dinars in sadaqah. Give it to the poor." And then the Prophet dozes off. He comes back. He gains consciousness and says, "Oh Aisha, did you give the 7 dinars in sadaqah? For what will I see on the day of judgment when Allah will ask me about the 7 dinars? Why did you leave this behind you? Why did you leave this with you? Why did you give this in sadaqah? Give this in sadaqah." Look at this. These companions, or the Prophet ﷺ and the companions, this is how they lived. They want to make sure that they have nothing left behind, that they give everything and divide everything. Imagine when you are going on a trip. When you are going on a trip, what do? You make sure there's nothing in the fridge that's gonna get bad. Everything is clear. You clean up the house. You want to make sure this is clean when you come back in 2 months or 3 months. But you're leaving for life. You're leaving for good. You want to make sure everything is distributed. Nothing is there with you that is haram or you owe anybody. "Oh Aisha, give this in sadaqah." So Aisha radiallahu anha, she gives this money in sadaqah. And then comes Monday. The 12th of Rabiul Awal, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he gains some strength and he opens the window from his room and he sees the ummah praying Fajr. Abu Bakr is leading salah and the ummah is praying Fajr, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has a big smile. He is happy because his mission is fulfilled. His mission was to prepare ummah that can connect with Allah and continue this salah, this pillar, the salah, and that he sees and he's happy with it. And you know, the Prophet says, if you want to be my companion in Jannah, you have to help me by increasing in your sujood, increasing in your salah. And that is the thing that we have completely neglected. And the Prophet sees this and he's extremely happy that the ummah is praying. And then the Prophet he could not come to the masjid, but he sees and he's happy. And then the companions say that we almost lost our salah. We almost lost our salah because from the side we could see the window of Rasulullah and him peeking through the window, and we almost lost our salah. We really want to finish our salah and look towards the face of Rasulullah. And so then what happens? Then the companions go to Rasulullah and say, Ya Rasulullah, you look good today. You look strong. You look fresh, alhamdulillah. And all the sahabas hug him and, you know, they're really happy. And then after that visit, the Prophet falls sick again and the fever goes back up really high. And the Prophet is now lying on the lap of Aisha radiallahu anha. The Prophet, he had his hand in a bowl of water and he was rubbing his forehead with that water. And he was saying, La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah, he was picking and he was rubbing his forehead with that. And then Fatima radiallahu anha, she enters the room. His daughter Fatima radiallahu anha enters the room and the Prophet calls Fatima and he whispers something in her ear and she starts crying. She starts crying. The Prophet then calls her again, Fatima, come here. And then the Prophet says something in her ear and she starts smiling. Later on, Aisha radiallahu anha asks, What did he say? What did Rasulullah say to you? And so Fatima radiallahu anha says, when the first time he called me, he says that Jibreel alayhi salam came to me twice this year. I think my time is near. And he says, yeah, and you will be the first to join me. And when she heard this, Fatima radiallahu anha starts crying that my father is leaving. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he called me back again, looking at my situation. He called me back again. He says, oh Fatima, aren't you happy that you're going to be the queen of all the women in Jannah? And then I smiled at that. And this is what the Prophet says, Fatima radiallahu anha. And Fatima radiallahu anha cries, oh my father, what's happening to my father? She could not take it in, the pain and the difficulty that he's going through. The Prophet says, oh my daughter, this is the last time your father will face this. After this, there is no pain. And then the Prophet is lying on the lap of Aisha radiallahu anha, and Abdurrahman, the son of Abu Bakr, enters with miswak in his pocket. And the Prophet's eyes went on the miswak, and Aisha radiallahu anha saw this, and then she gets a miswak from Abdurrahman bin Auf, and she softens, she chews and she softens the miswak for Rasulullah, because he is going to meet who? Rafiq al-A'la. He is going to meet the highest companion, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he wants to make sure that when I am presented in front of Allah, I want to be the best. And so Aisha radiallahu anha with her own mouth chooses and softens the siwak, and the Prophet uses the siwak. And what is he saying? La ilaha illallah, inna lil mawti la sakrat. La ilaha illallah, inna lil mawti la sakrat. There is no God but Allah. Verily, death has his pangs. Death has his pains that everybody has to go through. And then the Prophet Aisha radiallahu anha says that he saw something as he looked up, and he is as if that he saw something. When his eyes moved, he said he read this dua, Allahumma rafiq al-a'la, Allahumma rafiq al-a'la. Oh Allah, I choose the higher companion. Oh Allah, I choose the higher companion. You see, the prophets, when they die, they're given the choice. They don't die themselves. The angel comes and asks, would you like to leave this world out of honor and respect? And he chooses what? He chooses the Rafiq al-A'la, the better companion. And when she heard this, Aisha says, I made dua, Ya Allah, give him shifa. Cure him, Ya Allah, give him shifa. But the Prophet says, no, don't make dua for shifa. Rather make dua that I be with the higher companion. And then the Prophet's hand falls, and that comes, that is the end of Rasulullah. And the room was completely silent and people could not believe. And Aisha radiallahu anha starts crying, and then she sends a message to Abu Bakr saying the Prophet has passed away. And Hafsa radiallahu anha sends a message to her father saying the Prophet has passed away. And the first person to enter the room of Rasulullah was Umar radiallahu anha, because Abu Bakr was a kilometer or so away. And Umar radiallahu anha, when he enters with Mughira bin Shu'bah, and then he enters the room, and then as soon as he enters, before he enters, he knocks on the door, and Aisha radiallahu anha covers herself, and he enters and says, so unconscious, so unconscious, so deeply unconscious. And then he says this, and then he leaves the room. And then Mughira turns to Umar and says, "Oh Umar, he's not unconscious. Rasulullah is not unconscious, he has died." He says, "You're a liar. You're lying, he has not died. He cannot die. He has gone to Allah to see, he went to Allah just like Musa went to Allah. He cannot die." And then there's a commotion around outside the house of Rasulullah saying that, you know, Umar is shouting, "No, anybody who says he's dead, I'm going to chop his head off." Umar could not believe. And then comes Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu enters the room of Rasulullah, and then as he enters, all the other wives cover themselves up, and then Abu Bakr, he uncovers the cloth of Rasulullah from Rasulullah's forehead, and then he goes close and kisses his forehead. He kisses the forehead and he says, "Wa Safiya." He looks to the sky. After kissing, he looks to the sky. He says, "Oh, the chosen one. Ya Rasulullah. Oh, the chosen one." And then he bends down and then he kisses the forehead again. And he says, "Wa Rasulah. Oh, my messenger. Oh, my messenger. The death that was prescribed to you has already come upon you. After this day, there's no death upon you." And he says, "You smell as good as you were alive. You smell beautiful, Ya Rasulullah. May Allah have mercy on you." And then he covers himself and then he says, "Whatever Umar has said is a lie." And he goes out to the people and says, "Umar, sit down." He says, "Umar." He says, and he addresses all the people, that whoever worshipped Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, know that Muhammad has passed away. But whoever worshipped Allah, know that Allah is alive, ever living, never dies. وما محمد إلا رسول. Muhammad is nothing but a messenger. قد خلت من قبله رسل. Many messengers have passed away before him. أفإن مات وقتل انقلبتم على أعقابكم. If he dies or if he is killed, are you going to turn on your heels and turn away from him, turn away from the religion? وَمَنْ يَنْقَلِبَ عَلَىٰ عَقِبَيْهِ فَلَنْ يَضُرَ اللَّهَ شَيْئًا. Whoever turns away from his religion, he's only harming himself, he's not harming anybody else. Allah appreciates the one who is thankful, appreciative. And he says his ayah, and Umar says, "Is this in the Qur'an?" He's a hafiz of the Qur'an. He says, "Is this in the Qur'an?" He says, "Yes, it is in the Qur'an." And so Umar radiallahu, Abu Bakr, the one who was actually soft, became really strong at this time, and takes the Ummah forward. And these were the Sahabas, and Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he passes away on the 12th of Rabiul Awal, on a Monday, 10 years after Hijrah, at the age of 63. يَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهُ لِي وَلَكُمْ وَلِسَى الْمُسْلِمِينَ فَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهُ لِي وَلَكُمْ. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه والمولى. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. عباد الله، يرحمكم الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. بالصبر.